shite. That pretty much sums up that game. It finished in the Scottish Premiership. Rangers 1, Hearts 0. I predicted 1-1. I wasn't a million miles away, and maybe on another day it could have been 1-1. And if we'd have got an equaliser, I reckon we would have deserved it. But in the end, we didn't get it, and we didn't deserve it, and we deserved to lose because we did not do enough in this game against a really poor Rangers side. And I've got to look at both sides of the coin here. Robbie Nielsen, you can argue his tactics were negative tonight, and they were. But we were in this game right up to the last kick of the ball. It was 1-0 and we were in the game with a chance of taking points away. Now, we could have been more attacking. We could have been more adventurous. We could have went for it. And you know what? It might have paid off. We might have came and attacked Rangers and we could have scored one or two goals, you know, and we could have won the game. Like we did against Celtic at Tynecastle. I know we didn't win that, but we scored 3 goals and we gave them a really good matchup. We could have done that the night, but we also could have done that and it could have played into Rangers' hands and we could have came away with, you know, with a scalping. So it's easy with hindsight to bash the manager and say he got it wrong, he got it right. I expected Nielsen to set up this way. I didn't think we'd be too adventurous. I expected us to try and be compact and just defend and, you know, try and just stop Rangers from scoring, essentially. And if you can nick something, then by all means do it. We can see Rangers in recent weeks, you know, they've struggled to break teams down. So why would we make it easy for them? You know, it doesn't make a lot of sense. So I can kind of see why Nielsen went this way. He had Ginelli up front as well. I don't know if he thought maybe the pace of Ginelli would cause Rangers problems. And any time the ball was played over the top, I thought Ginelli did look like he could cause problems, but we just didn't get the ball up to him enough. There was a really good chance for him in the opening. It was like 12 minutes, 15 minutes, but unfortunately, a great ball over the top, by the way. I can't remember who it was by, but fantastic ball. Ginelli runs onto it, but Al McGregor just got in time to get to the ball first. Apart from that, like, there wasn't many chances for us. Cholak had a first time volley from a corner that was saved comfortably by Craig Gordon. John Lundstrom had a shot. It was Kemp with a pullback pass and Lundstrom blasted it over the bar, but that was pretty much it, guys, for the first half. Very quiet. Rangers got the goal in the 66th minute through Tillman. Probably Rangers' best bit of play of the entire game. Barisic passed into Tillman. Tillman shot, and it went underneath Craig Gordon's legs. You know, it was just one of those shit ones, right at the goalkeeper, but under his legs. And Nielsen made changes. We tried to get an equaliser. You know, there still wasn't any really clear-cut chances. If we're being honest, we were in the game, but to me, it felt like it was always going to end 1-0. You know, just Rangers didn't look like scoring a second. We didn't look like getting an equaliser. It was just one of those fucking shit games. And when I look back at it, man, Craig Gordon barely had, I mean, he didn't have a good save to make. Everything he done was comfortable. So it's not like Rangers peppered us. Yeah, they had more possession. They were in our half more, but you know, it was typical Rangers performance, you know, dominate possession, pass, 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 cross into the box, fucking nowhere, you know, rinse and repeat. So, yeah, no, I am disappointed. Win this game tonight, we would have moved up to third, so that was another incentive for us to go and get the job done tonight. But, I mean, look, We've got back-to-back wins coming into this game, so it did move us up the league table. We're now out of Europe. I am confident, guys. We've got one more game left. I believe it's against, is it St Mirren? I want to say St Mirren. I could be wrong. I'm going to say, is it St Johnstone, St Mirren? I can't remember, right? But we've got one more game left before the World Cup. Win that, and I think when we come back for the World Cup, I am convinced that we'll finish third. I'm not worried at all. You know, hopefully we've got close to a full strength team by then, and I believe we will kick on. And I'm not saying we're going to pull away and finish third easily, but I do think we will. I think we'll finish third with a couple of games to spare, put it that way. But yeah, tonight, very boring match. Horrible match. I mean, sometimes you get 1-0s and they're really good, but nah, this was one of those awful 1-0s where it was just like one good moment kind of decided the game, and unfortunately for us, guys, it went Rangers' way. So, yeah, that's it. Rangers keep the gap to Celtic at 7 points. Had they lost tonight or even drawn, I think Gio would have had to go. I think the pitchforks would have been out. I think Gio would have been stabbed up the ass, and I think he would have been chased out of Ibrox. And I'm sure there's a few people that will be wanting to chase Nielsen out of Tynecastle as well. So, you know what happens. Fans can do what they want, I guess. But, yeah. I mean, Nielsen should stay. Nielsen's done a good job at Hearts. Gio, on the other hand, I just don't. For me, to be blunt, I think if you're Rangers or Celtic manager, there's one question that you need to be able to answer correctly, and that question is, can you win the league? And for me, the answer to Gio's answer to that is no. I just don't see Gio beating Ange to the league, therefore I think Gio should go. But you know what? Fuck Rangers, fuck Gio, fuck everything, fuck football. Hurry up and have this shitey World Cup in the, you know, the blood money, the oil money. Just get this World Cup on, and I just don't want to watch football for a couple of months. I want a couple of months of football. Football free. From now, apart from Football Manager and FIFA, of course, I'll be playing that shit. But aye, guys, that's it, man. Shite game tonight. I can try and talk about it more, but it's not gonna make it any better. Dundee United, though, beat Kilmarnock 4-0, which I thought was a fucking weird result. Was not expecting that. And St Johnstone, you know, got a late equaliser against St Mirren, and I am sure Stephen Robinson will be pissed off with that. But you know what, Callum Davidson, fair play. St Johnstone stuck by him, and he's having a decent season this year. So, aye, fair play to St Johnstone. Anyway, guys, that's it. Leave your thoughts down below. Fucking shite game, man. I'd rather talk about any game apart from this game, because it was horrendous. Catch you in the next one. Peace.